Hello world, welcome to Rootmania. I am Sahil and today I am going to show you how to implement Google reCAPTCHA with contact us form using Bootstrap 4 and PHP. And in this tutorial I will also validate the form using Google reCAPTCHA and then send email using PHP. So let's start. So here you can see I have already created a directory inside htdoc and this is contact_reCAPTCHA. So first I will create a file inside this folder index.php and we will first include Bootstrap 4 CDN link here because I will use Bootstrap 4 for designing the form. So go to your browser and open getbootstrap.com and go below. Here you can see CSS only. So we need only CSS CDN link of Bootstrap 4. So just copy this link and paste inside your head tag. Okay, now just write a title for this page. So here I will write contact us form with Google reCAPTCHA. Okay, now here in body tag I will design the contact us form. So first create a container and inside this container create a row, inside this row create a column lg4. Now in body tag give a Bootstrap class for background color bg info, and in row just keep justify content center for centering this column, and here also bg light for background color, rounded for rounded corner, and margin top 3. Okay, now inside this column we will first create a heading. So here just use h4 tag and here write contact us. Okay, we will also give some Bootstrap class to this heading, text center text dark and padding 2. Okay, now just save this and go to your browser, open this project here using localhost / contact_reCAPTCHA. Okay, so this is our heading. Now just below this heading we will create our form. So here you can just write PHP shorthand tag and we will use this server super global variable method, and here we have to write PHP underscore self. Okay, and now here method equal to post, give some Bootstrap class to this form tag also like padding 2. Let's choose HTML. Okay, now inside this form tag I will first create a form group, and inside this I will create a input with type text name equal to name and class form control, and here I will use placeholder enter name. Okay, you can give required attribute. Now just copy the same thing, and now for the next input we will use email, and here just write email, and our next field is for the message field. So just remove this and write text area and name message, remove this, and here just keep class form control, and in row just give 4. You can also keep a placeholder for this. Write your message. Okay, write your message, and you can also give this field required attribute, and just save and go to the browser, refresh. So this is looking good. Now we just have to create a button. So just paste the same thing and just remove this, and here write input type submit, name submit, value send, and here keep some Bootstrap class button, button danger, button block. Okay, and just say go to the browser and refresh. So you can see the button now. So our contact form us page is ready. Now we have to implement the Google reCAPTCHA checkbox here. Okay, so for this go to Google and here search reCAPTCHA and just open the first link. Go to the admin console and now from here we just have to give a label. So for my case I am just showing you, so here I am giving example 1. Okay, and I will use Google reCAPTCHA version 2 with I am not robot checkbox. Okay, so just select this, and here we are using on localhost, so we have to write localhost in domain name. Okay, click on accept reCAPTCHA terms and services, and just you can just check this or not, it's up to you. Okay, now click on submit. So this is our site key and this is secret key, so we will use it later. So just click on this, see client side integration, click on this. So here you will see some codes, so just copy this code and paste just below the closing body tag. Okay, just paste this, and now just copy this line and paste where you want to put the Google reCAPTCHA checkbox. Okay, so I will keep just below this text area. So here I will also use div.formGuru and just paste. Here you can see a data site key. So here we have to paste the site key. So you just go to here and this is our site key. So just copy this code and paste here. Okay. Paste and just save this. Go to your browser, refresh. So here you can see this is the checkbox from the Google reCAPTCHA is showing here. Now go to the text editor again, and we will use PHP to send email, but before sending the email we will just verify the content by clicking this checkbox and then send email. Okay, so for this just go here and I will use PHP. So just select PHP and write PHP script here. So first I will just write a function error reporting 0, and I will create a message variable that is empty. And now I will use if it's set and I will use this super global variable post method, and here I will check each submit. Now when we click on this submit button, you can see this is our submit button, and we have assigned a value in name attribute submit. So we are checking using this button. So if the button is pressed, then we will do the other stuff. So first I am creating variables to a store, like where we want to receive the email after sending from the site. So we are sending to wolfmania44@gmail.com. okay, now what is the subject line? So we can just write in subject form submission. Okay, form submission, and we will create a name and just grab the name from the form, and for email we will also use same method and write the name attribute value here, email, and for message we will use same and just write message. Now I will create message body, so here I will write message body equal to, so here I will first show name, and here we will print the name, and we can write has written you, and here message variable. Okay, so this is our message body. Now we just have to create our headers. Header equal to from, and here we just have to write email. Okay, and now we will create variable for secret key equal to, so here we have to paste the secret key from the reCAPTCHA. So this is our secret key, so just copy and paste here. Okay, we will create one more variable, response key. So we can get response key by using this post method, and here we have to write gCAPTCHA response. Okay, gCAPTCHA response. Now you can check here, we are using server side validation, so we are verifying the user's response before doing anything. So just click on here, verify the user's response, and you can see by using these parameters, post parameters, we will verify the content of the users by clicking this checkbox, I am not a robot. Okay, so go here and just copy this link, create a variable URL, and paste this variable here. Now I will just write question mark sign, and I will here use this secret, so just copy paste equal to secret key. This is our secret key, so we are just assigning secret equal to this secret key. Okay, and we can also use this response, this is also required, you can see here, so we have to response equal to now this response key. Okay, so just copy and here paste. Okay, response key. There is one optional field you can check remote IP, but this is not required, so I'm just leaving this. So you can check, but I'm leaving for now. Now I will create a variable response equal to file get content and here pass the URL. Okay, URL, and I'm just checking echo response. Go to the browser, refresh this, and here when I am entering something hello, and when I am not clicking checking this I am not a robot checkbox and click on send, then you can see a success false. Okay, and if we write something here and hello and check here and then click on send, then you can see success equal to true. So here you can see these are like JSON format, so we have to just remove this line and here use same variable response, and here I will use JSON decode and just pass response. Okay, now we will decoded the JSON format. Now we will use in if condition by using this response variable. Okay, so here we just have to write response and we will check using this success. If response is success, then we will send the message email. Okay, so here we will use if statement again and calling the mail function, and here just write two variable and here subject variable and here message body and here headers. Okay, now if the mail is sent successfully, then we can simply show a message to this message variable, message sent successfully. Okay, and if some error occurs, then we can show error message like failed to send the message. Okay, and here just use else and message verification failed. Verification failed. Okay, now save this and go to your browser, refresh this. Now when I am writing the name, the email ID and some message, hello there, how are you? Okay, and if I'm not checking this, I am not a robot checkbox and clicking on send, then oh sorry, we did not call this message variable into the form. So just below this button I will call this. So here just form group and here I will use h4 tag and I will use php shorthand tag and call this message variable, and here just give some bootstrap class text text success and text center. Okay, save this, go to your browser again, just refresh this and write something. Email ID, hello there, how are you? Okay, just copy this, and when I am just clicking the send button, then you can see verification failed because we did not check this Google reCAPTCHA checkbox. Okay, but and the email is also not to send. Okay, so we can check, just open Gmail. So you can see the mail is not received here. Now go to the contact form again and write the name, email, and write the message and click on the checkbox, I am not a robot. And after verified, then click on send. Then you here you can see message sent successfully. Okay, now go to your inbox and here you can see message has been received from this subject form submission, and here you can also see the content name, Sahil Kumar has written you, hello there, how are you? Okay, so this is working fine. So thanks for watching this video guys. If you like this video, then hit on like button and please subscribe my channel.